Good morning, everyone. So we got our spectrum in. It was over 14 hours that it measured the samples. And we'll go ahead and review that now.
Okay, so 15 hours and 32 seconds. Or 15 hours and 32 minutes, sorry. And as you can see, our lead box worked out wonderfully. The count rate is 445 m. CPS, which is basically 0.453 counts per second. So it's really drastically dropped the background, and it really cleaned up the signal that we got here. So here's our search. You can see lots of times it's down in zero, but very, very minuscule. So we're only pretty much primarily getting what these samples contain. Okay. Go ahead and go to the spectrum here. Bring the filter down a little bit. Okay, so this is our spectrum. And if you look at this stuff often, you can tell that this spectrum has definitely changed from what normally occurs. Up here on this left side, you have what's known as your normal X-ray until you get, you have this big peak of low energy X-rays that occur in the background, right? And what we see here is an iodine peak, iodine-131 peak, right? Radium, radium-226, that's the other iodine-131 peak. It's very, very small, very, very, very small. We have a little bit of thorium, right, in there. A little bit of radium-226. Let's zero that in a little bit better here. Radium-226. Come on, peak. Get on there. Stick with me. Radium-226. 226. The other iodine-131 peak. Iodine-131 peak. Okay, annihilation peak with the electron positron annihilation. So cool, we can see that in the detector. So 153, natural stuff. Radium-226. A little bit of cesium-137, which is ubiquitous. Okay. So we're not seeing anything of note. Okay, anything that would be considered more than background. We'll go around the uranium peak. Let's see, where is it? 9. Here we go. So it should be 1,000. Right around 1,000 is uranium. So yeah, nothing major. It's all natural. This is what naturally occurs. And we don't have a whole lot of it. There's not huge peaks. Right, except for the iodine-131, which has a half-life of 8 days, right? So with the natural uranium in there, the thorium, yeah, we're going to have that. So after 15 and a half hours, we got us a good signal. We got us a good measurement. We got quite a bit of the background blocked out using our lead our malleable lead. So we kind of prove that with just a roll of lead that you don't need a huge lead castle to actually get things done in the field. Okay. You can use the malleable lead to block out much of the signal and then go from there. And it makes it much easier to look through all the noise and you're able to clean it up, right? So we got it cleaned up. It's a nice clean. We see our peaks. This is your potassium 40 peak. That's also ubiquitous in the environment, right? It's all your high energy stuff, but that's your typical stuff that you would find. Thorium 232. This is our typical stuff that we would find. Thorium 232. Yep. So the sample is clear. The area is clear from what I can see, from the areas that I searched and from the core sample that I measured. If there is contamination in that area, then it's deeper than a foot, right? And it's not spread, or it could be, you know, less than a foot, but it's not spread even. It's not a large amount of contamination. So the Weldon Spring disposal area and the Weldon Spring quarry, I am going to clear and say that it's not contaminated from the surface area and definitely not contaminated from my sample that I took. So I hope this helps everybody, and I thank you for watching. Bye.